Hello and welcome back to Proactive, where I'm talking with Gil Holtzman, who's the Chief Executive at Eco Atlantic Oil and Gas. Gil, it's great to see you. How are things?
Hi, Thomas. Good morning and happy summer.
Happy summer to you as well. We saw that there was some news from you earlier this week, but before we delve into the details there, Gil, could you just get us back up to speed with the company and what it is you do over there?
Yes, thank you, Thomas. Eco Atlantic is probably the most exciting pure exploration, oil and gas exploration company, listed on AIM and on TSX. We are focused on exploration in the hottest basins around the world at the moment. The Guyana-Suriname basin on the one hand, and of course the Namibia and South Africa, where we have a presence in the Walvis Basin in Namibia and in the Orange Basin in the South African side. We have 2 blocks in South Africa, 4 blocks in Namibia, and an exposure to 2 blocks in Guyana. One is directly working interest by us, and one is through an investment that we made in another company. So all in all, we have 8 blocks in the 3 most exciting regions for exploration in the world, neighbors to all the super majors, neighbors to the biggest discoveries made in the past 10 years in Guyana, the Stabroek block, of course, with 13 billion barrels. And now in Namibia, with the latest discoveries, 4 discoveries made by Shell and 2 discoveries made by Total, and that keeps on going.
Fantastic. And it was at one of your blocks in South Africa where there was some news just this week. You sold a stake for $10.5 million. Perhaps you can give us a bit of an overview of the deal you've struck there.
Yes, that's correct. Actually, this deal is the first in what we plan to be a series of transactions that are designed to boost shareholders' value, to boost the company's value. The deal, as you mentioned, we sold a small stake. We had 26.25% in the very sought after and prospective block 3B4B in Orange Basin in South Africa. And we sold 6.25% to our strategic aligned partner and the operator of the block, which is Africa Oil. Naturally, Africa Oil is a much bigger company and they're the operator of the block. So it made a very good sense to balance the working interest percentage such that Africa Oil will have a bigger stake than Eco Atlantic. We still remain with 20% working interest, which is exactly our bite size. So the deal, as I said, not only that it rebalances the block ownership between Africa Oil and ourselves, it also leverages our negotiation position with very big potential third parties that are currently in discussions and in negotiations with us. Africa Oil is the operator. They're leading these discussions. It also frees up cash for us to execute on other deals that we're currently working on. I cannot say too much, but it frees up some important cash for us to execute on other deals in the same profile of blocks that we have. And it frees up cash with no shareholders dilution. And it paves the way for, as I said, for the series of transactions that we are contemplating for the summer and towards the end of the third quarter, that we will, of course, let the market know when executed. So, as I said, it made a very good sense, not only for Block 3B4B, rebalancing the working interest, also gives us a lot of free cash for us to execute on other deals. And one should remember that we bought these 6.25% just a year ago for $10 million worth of shares that we issued at 30p. Today, our share price is around 14p. So basically, and we sold for $10.5 million. So basically, that was a very creative way for us to cash up, not dilute shareholders, and still remain with a very considerable 20% working interest on this block going forward for a third-party farming.
Absolutely, Gil. So have you managed to get a sense so far of how people have reacted to the deal?
Again, people only read it about it 2 or 3 days ago when we issued the press release. The sophisticated investors, some of them, of course, called us and asked more detailed questions about the deal. They understand the rationale. They understand what it entails for the company going forward. They really like the fact that we managed to boost our balance sheet with no shareholders dilution. They understand that Africa Oil is now in a much better position to negotiate a third party farm in. And they understand it has a much broader effect on the rest of our portfolio and the rest of our business going forward without the need to raise cash from shareholders or to go to the market and raise capital. So the sophisticated investors really understand it. And I'm here speaking with you, Thomas, in order to make sure that everyone else understands it.
All understood. Thank you very much indeed, Gil. And is there anything else you'd like to add before we say goodbye today?
As I say, we are under strict confidentiality with many parties in many aspects of our business in Guyana, in Namibia, and in South Africa. So there's not too much I can say, but all I can say is that pay close attention and have a look at our announcement in the coming few months. And that will basically, that will paint the bigger picture that we're currently working on.
Very intriguing. Hopefully we'll get another update from you then, Gil. But it's been great getting this one. And thank you very much indeed for your time today.
Thomas, thank you very much and have a lovely weekend.